We have Varun Lohchab now joining us, as promised, from HDFC Securities, who is now joining us in our studios. He is now heading the institutional research at HDFC Securities. Varun, hi, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
It's been a sharp, sharp downtick for the market. Of course, we're not taking last hour into account. But you think this is a time to build some portfolios? Are you using this decline to actually buy into stocks?
Yeah, so I think these sort of declines should be used to buy the stocks which you like, you know, so your investing philosophy and style cannot change because of, you know, market volatility. And that's what we have tried to, you know, come out with in our latest strategy report, that you stick to the fundamentals and keep buying the stocks, you know, where you see relative risk reward being quite good. And in fact, some of those stocks are getting even more attractive in this recent, you know, market correction in the last 10-15 days. So I would use it as an opportunity, because frankly, overall valuations, though headline Nifty valuations are still slightly above long-term averages, but if you look at on a bottom-up basis, there are enough stocks which are trading at fairly attractive, you know, valuations and still offer a good medium-term growth. So that's what, you know, that's how we would like to position ourselves in our portfolios.
Okay. By the way, we're expecting a cabinet briefing, and I think the finance minister is going to be addressing the press as well. When that happens, we'll of course go to it and find out what the decisions were, if there's anything important that's come out. But in the meantime, Varun, you know, let's also talk about the latest report that you guys came out with, the note, which is looking at the model portfolio. And I'm straight away going to get to that, because everybody wants to know how to create that right portfolio. You are overweight on financials, on cement, on chemicals, IT and telecom. Let me first take the chemicals piece of that, because it's a large amorphous group. And right now there's so much of supply chain disruption going on. I mean, the API ban that came in yesterday itself. What kind of chemical companies do you like?
So, you know, I think this as a sector has been in a structural, you know, strong growth trajectory. And probably these sort of events can catalyze the growth for some of the companies as supply chains, you know, shift more towards India. So we cover, you know, right now a few stocks like Navin Fluorine, which also, you know, we like. We like Alkyl Amines, which is a small cap. We like Galaxy Surfactant. So they cater to different kind, you know, end user industries, pharma, agro, consumer, and, you know, so they are a play on growth in these industries, plus market share gain globally from, you know, players around the globe. So, and valuations also are reasonable, though the stocks have run up and now are not, I would say, particularly cheap, but the sort of growth runway they have makes us, you know, quite positive on this space.
Okay, am I reading it right? You have ITC as part of your, as your top bet. You know, it's frustrated so many people now, Varun. You know, what's going on here? Tell us, and you know, what makes you bullish on ITC? 187 on the stock. I mean, look at that. It's almost looking like a mid-cap stock.
So, you know, a whole host of reasons have been there behind the derating, but what we were quite surprised with was the extent of derating. If you look at last 5 years, you know, the stock has still given high single digit sort of a EPS growth CAGR, but the valuations have more than halved. And you know, there are combinations like ESG factor being one. You know, second is obviously the whole tobacco derating across the globe. And we believe you know, some of these things are temporary, and you know, given the earning growth is still going to remain in high single digits in our view over the medium term, and now the dividend yield is approaching 4-4.5%. Valuations are at 13-14 times. If you X out the value of other FMCG businesses and all, probably core tobacco is trading at, you know, 12-13 P. So we believe it offers a very good, you know, risk reward at this stage, especially after this, you know, recent correction post budget when the duties were hiked. So you know, we have included in our model portfolio with a 300 bips for weight.
Yeah, by the way, could the market get into the green today? Well, that will be stunning if it happens. Now only 34 points down on the Nifty. So, well, you never know, but from the low point, there it is. 11,080 was the low, and from 11,080 to 11,266, we are at the cusp of a 200-point intraday recovery, your last ever recovery, Surabhi. Yeah. And for all you know, perhaps, I don't know, you whether know, we turn into the green or not.
You know, Anuj, and also let's not forget, again, pull up the global picture. How much will the Indian bear sort of, you know, run his or her luck? Our futures right now are up 544 points. They were up 350 points when we started. So to what extent can you keep ignoring it? There's a big global rebound underway. Then do you want to keep shorts open and bet against it? Maybe that's something that people are thinking about. There you go, there's a 2% rebound. That's what the S&P futures are indicating, at least right now. But Varun, I'm going to get back to your model portfolio list because there are more interesting names on it. You've got some of the banks as well, like Axis and SBI. We've seen the correction play out on SBI, and I'll tell you what. We were talking to India Ratings on their latest note because they came out with a bit of a scare saying there'll be a second wave of NPA, 2.5 lakh crores worth of corporate debt could turn bad. I'm just wondering if those kind of headlines worry you when you talk about corporate lenders?
Now, again, you know, if you look at an aggregate basis, based on our analysis, doesn't look like the level of NPAs or stress in the system is going to increase materially. It increased a little bit on a Q-on-Q basis in this quarter, but still, you know, compared to the sort of pain we saw a couple of years back, I think we are past that phase, and you are going to see incremental sort of NPA stress coming down, and therefore, ICICI, you know, Axis, SBI, all three of them feature in our, you know, model portfolio with overweight positions.
Bharti Airtel, that's been the stock of the last 1.5 years. It was a top gainer last year, it's a top gainer this year as well. This whole duopoly and the fact that Bharti will benefit, is that now in the price, or do you think it can keep surprising on the upside?
Yeah, so I think some of the easy money in that turnaround story has been made. But frankly, if you just try and you know, portray the picture 2 to 3 years out in terms of what the ARPUs could be with you know, that sort of an industry structure, we believe there is still you know, enough room for earning surprises and valuation you know, re-rating in that stock. So therefore, though you know, we are not very early into the story as of now, but I think it still has enough legs to kind of keep delivering good returns even from these levels over the next couple of years.
Okay, well, Varun, I'll tell you what, it's a good time that we were discussing your model portfolio. It coincided with the market recovery, so it seems people are, you know, out there and realizing this is not the end of the world, and hopefully we should have things under control. That's what we are dealing with. Thank you very much for joining us on the show today. Hope to see more of you. Okay, there are